Hello, this is Sam with the Awesome Gardens YouTube channel. I'm just now starting these videos. I am apparently very bad at making videos because I've accidentally deleted about 5 or 6 videos, so I'm having to redo these again. But anyway, I'm glad that you're here. I'm going to show you what I'm doing in my backyard. I'm turning my entire backyard into a garden, a raised bed square foot garden. And I'll be making videos as I go along, and I'm just going to do a quick view of my backyard, and we're going to show you how I'm going to turn this junky backyard into a beautiful garden. And this is my daughter Miranda. Say hi, Miranda.
Hi.
Good job. And we're going to walk through this with you, okay? Okay, now, this is just a little workstation that I have set up. I've got a few saw horses here at the edge of my driveway. And there's some drills. And a saw. And I'm just using that to put together some wood. Now what I did was... Now what I did was I put an ad in my local paper, the American Classifieds. I live here in Texarkana, Texas. And I had two people... I give me calls, two good calls, and one of them had these crates, and look at the side of this crate. I want to have another video. Okay. One person had crates, and another person had a bunch of pallet wood, and I'll show you what I did with that. Another stack of this is just some things that I picked up for free, and some of this I'm going to put to use as like maybe a raised bed garden edge. I got some free rebar that I might use for different purposes, and a lot of this is going to be reusable. Look at this. What does this look like?
Daddy, my daddy.
Well, to me that looks like a big tomato trellis. So I'm going to put together. I'm going to just try to reuse as much as I can. Now I'm going to show you this around here. What I'm doing. Basically, this is all the wood that still has some nails in it and everything. And then right here, I just have a hammer, and I'm taking out all the nails. And I got some about 5.5-inch thick pieces and some about 3-inch pieces. And I'm putting those together over here in my workstation. Now I have another pile of wood over here. Just random size wood. Against my fence, and I'm going to use a lot of these as stakes and other sides and posts for my raised bed garden and things like that. And so just try to reuse whatever you can use and do the best you can with what you have. And I'm trying to do this on a very low budget. Also, this here is my trailer, and I do have a lawnmower. And what I do is I back my trailer and lawnmower up in here, and I've got a compost pile going back here in the back. And I'll talk a little bit about my compost pile. Okay, first, I wanted to talk about this. Come here, sweetheart. Alright. This is my compost right here. And I get this for pretty cheap here in Texarkana at the Texarkana Waterworks place, I believe. And I get the compost for about $5 for a half yard, which fills up the back of my truck. And it will almost fill, I've noticed it will almost fill a 12-foot by 4-foot raised bed about 6 inches high. Almost. Not quite. It'll probably fill it about 4 inches high. And here I got a little bit of peat moss in these two bags and vermiculite.
Mommy.
You okay? Did you get stuff in your foot again? Now the peat moss I've noticed is the cheapest at Lowe's here in town. It's about $10 for 3 cubic feet. The vermiculite I get at a store called the North 40. It's about $18 for a 4-cubic bag. And I was using this a lot to mix in my raised beds, but I'm going to use just compost and rock dust minerals. And I'll give some more information about that as I go along. If you want some more information about rock dust minerals, watch Growing Your Greens with John Kohler. He's got some really good videos, and I've watched most of them, and he's part of the inspiration for me doing this. let's just continue on back here. Right here I got a post in the ground, another post coming out of the ground. And I'm going to build a gate right here and put a fence. I'm going to put a fence along the back of this garden here. Good job. And I'm going to use this black netting material and just build it across here. It's only going to be about 4 feet high. Now right here between my driveway where I have my workstation and the gate will be about right in here. I've got another small space and I'll put some raised beds here. And then right here where my daughter is walking, I've got all these boards laid out. See that? And all these boards laid out right along here. I'm going to build a greenhouse. This is the PVC. I bought some 3/4 inch PVC. And I'm just going to build a greenhouse from here all the way across to the other side. Just a little hoop house, and I'll have a video about that. That should be very interesting. So there'll be my greenhouse, and then here's my back. Here's the back right corner. Look at my daughter on my lawnmower. Say hi, Miranda. Miranda, say hi to everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Yeah, isn't she sweet? Right here I've got a big pile of topsoil, and I'm digging out the topsoil in my yard, and I'll show you why I'm doing that. And right here is my compost pile, and I do believe I'll have a few videos about my compost pile. And that is really neat. And this, I keep it moist. Look how moist it is. And that is actually heating up very well and breaking down very well. And I've turned it about 3 times already. And I do pour a few buckets of water on top of my compost to keep it moist. And I'll talk about that in another video. Alright, now I want to share a few plants with you that I grew last year. And I grew this in mostly compost. A little bit of peat moss and vermiculite mixed in. Looky here, this is beautiful. I have my kale plant, and this thing is like a little bush. Looky here. Now kale, from what I understand, is one of the most nutrient dense rich foods. It's gonna be really good to juice with orange juice, apple juice, anything like that. It's not the best kale I've had. A little bit bitter, but I'm going to experiment with several different kinds of kale this year. Oops. And here I have my broccoli. Look at this. This is January. And I have bees in my broccoli. This is mid-January and I have bees in my broccoli. Wow. My flowering broccoli. Isn't that neat?
Wow.
See, here's a regular little broccoli top.
Wow.
That's good.
Wow.
Here's a little flowering top.
Wow.
That's good as well. But this is what happens when you let broccoli go too far. It'll send up these long shoots. Yellow flowers. But this plant is just covered in broccoli, and it's so much to eat. Randy, you want a piece of broccoli?
Uh-huh. That's a little broccoli.
It is a little broccoli. Yeah, good. I want to show you one thing right here. I use this swimming pool to cover up my compost when it's close to raining. Let me give you a view here of what I'm doing. Right here is going to be my greenhouse. I'll have a few raised beds right here with my gate right there. A few raised beds. My greenhouse I'm standing in. I might have another few raised beds over here in some space. Got my compost pile. Got my two big raised beds here I'll probably build some more on this edge over here. And these are pre-made raised beds also. Got a 4x4 here, 4x8, and a 4x8. I'm going to join those together, join this together, join this together. Those are three big rows right here. These rows will be about 25 feet long. And I'll have another one right here. That's where I'm digging out my topsoil. Look at this. That's the topsoil I'm digging out. I'm putting along the edge of my fence over there. Now I wanted to show you why I was digging this out. Look at these roots right here. These roots are very mean. They grow like crazy. This is some tough grass, very mean grass, hard to get rid of. Let me show you what happened last year. Here's another place I'm digging this out to raise to this raised bed. And this is what happened last year. Last year I put this weed guard down that I bought from Lowe's. And you know what? It did not work at all. You want to sit with me? Okay. Miranda wants to sit with me. This is one of the great things about building a garden in your backyard is you get to share it with others. Isn't that right? Oh, you hurt your toes. See, I told her we needed to put some socks on. And you didn't listen to me. Let me show you this grass real quick. See this grass just... Yeah, I got my weed guard down here. And this grass just grew straight through it. See those little roots just grew right through it. And it just kept growing. Look at this grass just coming right up. Ow. Better. And that's pretty much it. I want to back up here and show you a big view of my garden. Of course, I do have another pile of wood right here I need to sort through. Some pallet wood and stuff like that. So, here's the edge of my house. Got a stack of wood to sort through. Some more wood to sort through. It's where I'm digging. Some more raised beds. And I wanted to show this to you. I bought 16 55-gallon drums for $5 a piece. So it's $80 invested here. I'm going to turn this into a rain collection system. And the plan is to catch a lot of water with this from runoff from my house. I should have a video about that as well. So stay tuned for some interesting videos. Rainwater collection system installation coming up. I do plan to put an irrigation system in my garden. That ought to be fun. I'm going to experiment around, see what I can do for very cheap. I have several more raised beds to build, and this is my yard. There's my pile I'm going to have to sort through. My gate is going to be right there. There's my trailer. And you will see this transform. You should see this transform over time into a nice, clean backyard, or a lush garden, a lush raised bed garden. So it's going to be a lot of work, but a lot of fun as well. Hope you stay tuned and learn how to grow your own food. And the most important thing I found, just as everybody else seems to agree, just get started. I have a lot of inspiration from Mel Bartholomew with Square Foot Gardening. I will show you a few other books as well that kind of motivated me. And Growing Your Greens channel on YouTube is very encouraging as well. John Kohler does a good job with his videos. I've watched most of them. So watch those videos, read your books, grow your own food, and I hope you stay tuned for my videos.